Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to our worldwide audience here. Thank you so much for joining us today. I'm Brian Chappell, Director of Content Strategy and Marketing at Imagia, and also the voice of the Imagia AI for Finance podcast. Before we get started here, I would just like to go over a few housekeeping items before we get going. First of all, we'd like to ask that you mute your audio for the duration of this important presentation. Secondly, we are happy to encourage participation. We just ask that you write any questions you have for our esteemed presenters in the Zoom chat. We will address those during the Q&A session later in the call. If for some reason we are unable to get to any of your questions during today's broadcast, please know that we'll be happy to answer those questions by email within the next couple of days. Finally, we will be making a recording of this webinar available on demand within a few days, this presentation as well. So let's get to our esteemed panelists here. For today's webinar, we have with us Kalyan Manyam. He is the Vice President of Enterprise Content Services for Solix. Our next guest is Vina Gundavelli. She is the founder and CEO of Imagia, the leading provider of cloud-based autonomous finance solutions for order to cash. So let's jump right in and get started with Kalyan. If you could go ahead and give us an introduction to cloud document management systems, that'd be great. Take it away.
Great. Thank you, Brian. Hello and welcome, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us on this webinar today, and also to those who will be listening to it afterwards. I'm Kalyan Manyam. I'm the Vice President of Enterprise Content Services at Solix Technologies. I have been with the company for over 8 years now in various leadership roles, and I have over 20 years of experience in the technology industry itself. So today we are here to discuss how organizations like yours can future-proof finance document management by leveraging the latest and the best cloud and AI technologies that are available today. So let's begin by first looking into the current state of the finance document management, right? Well, according to Gartner, historically, organizations have deployed, multiple narrow or overly broad document management solutions. Some are on-prem, some are in the cloud. Think on-prem servers, network drives, employee devices, collaboration platforms like Google Drive, OneDrive, cloud storage platforms, custom applications, and there's so many more, right? And as you can see, all of this has created content silos. And over time, some of these solutions also have become legacy in the sense they're no longer used and are required to be around because they still contain data that is critical for historical business reference or for compliance reasons. So what you see here in the slide is a classic case of content silos that have gone out of control, right? There are still multiple use cases being supported, but at the same time, they've brought in a lot of inefficiencies into how teams are actually performing their activities around those documents, with those documents. And this, in fact, is true across many organizations today. And this chaos challenges the productivity of finance teams and their ability to properly govern their data or their documents and also handle compliance efficiently as well, right? So it's very important that we understand this properly. So let's double click on this a little further. So what we have here is on the right side of this slide deck, on the slide, I have listed for you the common challenges faced by finance departments. Again, this is something that we have understood having spoken to several finance teams across several organizations. The challenges include the document collection and organization, your inability to access information when you need it, your internal and external collaboration, your governance and compliance, your data security and data loss prevention, your inability to adopt AI as well has been a critical challenge, because when your data is not in a centralized location, your ability to adopt the latest AI technologies also gets significantly limited as well. And also having to manage all of these repositories is becoming more and more expensive, while at the same time organizations are looking to cut down costs and become more efficient so that they can leverage their budgets towards more high-yielding activities, right? So let's look at how some of these challenges actually relate to some of the functions of the finance teams, right? So right here on the slide, I have the customer and vendor onboarding. I'm sure, you know, as teams that you're, you know, as members who are managing all of these onboarding processes, you are today, you know, engaging with your customers or vendors through email. You're engaging and collecting documents through, you know, maybe customer applications that have been built by your organizations to, you know, help onboard these vendors or customers. And again, once you collect those documents, you need to download them, put them, organize them, you know, in a centralized place, and then again internally securely share them for the internal review and the approval process. As you can see, instead of trying to focus more on providing efficient and faster service, you're now focused on collecting the documents, organizing the documents, and trying to work through the emails and work through the approval and email process, you know, approval processes through email as well, which is very, very time consuming as well, right? And again, as an accounting department, you are probably, you know, handling large volumes of documents, maybe for your general ledger entries. You're probably, you know, looking into your accounts payables, your accounts receivables. There are several invoices, POs that you're every day managing and looking into. And then you also have the payrolls data that you are probably, you know, managing as well. And it's very important that you have immediate access to all of this information at any time, because you need to be able to not only execute on making payments timely, but also be able to respond to your vendor queries or customer queries so that you can receive your cash into the company as well, you know, faster. So the fact that, okay, some of this data is not easily available takes sometimes weeks of time for you to be able to respond to vendor or supply queries. And that actually delays your ability to, you know, function at your best, right? And the second, the third here is the financial planning and analysis, right? So teams here are very, very, focused on working on accurate data. They want to be working on the latest data. They want to be able to ensure they're able to collaborate internally with several members, both within the finance team and outside the finance team as well, so that they can perform their planning and budgeting and cash flow analysis in a much more efficient manner and also in a timely manner as well, right? And today, you know, with the fact that data is distributed all over the place and it's becoming difficult to share information with, you know, internally, that is actually hindering their ability to, provide timely analysis, on all the financial data that's available today. And if you also look at the treasury and the audit compliance and regulatory, functions, all of these functions also are all, hindered by the fact that information is distributed, which means it is impossible or sometimes extremely time consuming for you to find information of relevance. Think of audits, it could be internal audit or external audit, where you have teams that are coming in and asking for information over the last few years, and you need to be able to pinpoint and quickly find all the information to be able to serve and respond to those audit queries as well, right? And also you have the regulatory reporting, which means you need to be able to report on a timely basis to be able to comply with these regulations. And also now, as much as, not many people realize, but finance teams are today holding a lot of PII information, right? Personally identifiable information about their customers, about their vendors, suppliers, and even their own employees as well. And all of this is regulated by various data privacy regulations, such as GDPR, by HIPAA, by CCPA, as a California specific privacy regulation, right? And several others as well. And it's important that you're able to protect all of this sensitive information appropriately to be able to be stay in compliance with all of these regulations too, right? And then you also have your vendor, investor relations. You have your corporate dev, where you are externally, you're not only collecting a lot of documents, but also communicating and sharing all of these documents with several external stakeholders. It could be your investors, or it could be the M&A partners that you're working with. But there's a lot of documents that you're that's flowing through And there's, and you also need to collaborate around those documents too. It's just not about sharing. It's not about just collecting documents, but also collaborating around specific documents on an ongoing basis to be able to, you know, get complete specific activities that you're working on today, right? And the inability to, the fact that, okay, all of this content silos exist is, you know, is hindering the ability of finance teams to deliver efficiently on their functions. So I think it's time for a quick audience poll. Brian, Nakshay, I think what we are trying to assess is also, you know, what are the biggest challenges that you're, as a finance team, you know, are facing today with your document management and systems. We have a few, we'll wait probably around like 25, 30 seconds, and then we'll take it from there. I can see the response are flowing in. Thank you. Perfect. So as you can see, I think the results are, you know, very clearly stating that the document organization and retrieval has become a challenge. Even though most organizations today have an existing document management system in place, that still seems to be a major challenge. The manual processes and errors in terms of how you are processing those documents, you know, either for general ledger entries or maybe for processing or reviewing your invoices or, you know, employee expense claims, right? So all of those activities are extremely time consuming, and I think it's quite clearly evident, you know, at least from the poll results also, it reflects whatever we have actually been seeing in the market and with our customers today, right? So the answer to all of these challenges today, you know, potentially lies in the cloud, and how you're able to leverage it, and also with AI, because the unified document management can actually address the challenges of information availability and accessibility and collaboration. And the fact that, okay, AI can come in and help you with document data extraction and document data processing and add a lot more intelligence around how you process and work around those documents too, right? So in fact, you know, let me share a few stats, from various analyst firms today that have, you know, for example, here, Forrester talks about how 60% of organizations have realized that they do not want to be managing these cloud, these data document management systems on-prem any longer, because one, they are unable to take care of the security. There's a lot of maintenance that gets involved. The reliability of the systems is a big challenge. And with also so many data breaches and data security challenges and the compliance requirements, and the fact that, okay, these various document repositories that are on-prem on the cloud have different capabilities, they're unable to essentially implement uniform data security and uniform governance. So they are looking towards slowly consolidating and moving to the cloud. And the primary benefits that they are exploring and expecting is increased resiliency around how their data is available to them, their ability to, you know, improve their business agility as well, because they want to be able to respond to customer queries, move faster, complete their tasks faster so that they can actually improve their cash flow or improve their sales. At the same time, they are also moving to the cloud for access to continuous innovation, right? Because especially when you're looking to leveraging SaaS providers, there's a continuous stream of innovation that's coming in and new capabilities coming into the platform almost on a weekly or a bi-weekly basis into those new platforms. And all of those platforms, for example, at Solix, on the Solix platform, you get access to all of those capabilities at no additional cost. And you have immediate access without any disruption to any of the existing processes on your end as well, right? And there's also a significant promise around lowering your cost of managing your document management. And there's close to 22% of the leaders are looking towards lowering their cost by leveraging cloud. Here, you know, this research is from Gartner, and Gartner here refers to how AI is transforming the business world today. and how leaders in these various organizations are looking to leverage AI to improve their employee productivity, right? So close to 60% of them are expecting that AI can be leveraged today to improve their employee productivity. But the fact is, the finance team is not at the forefront of this innovation today. They are at least 2x behind other functions in using AI. That's also probably because of the fact that most of the large language models or the chat GPTs or various technologies out there are open source or probably public, you know, really available technologies, and they're not easily available or cannot be leveraged by finance teams because you're essentially dealing with a lot of confidential data, you know, that requires a lot more security as well, right? So you are, again, compliance and privacy risks are also very high. And so hence the finance teams are treading this water a little bit more cautiously. And that's where I think, you know, vendors like Solix and Imagia can come in and help you navigate and, you know, enable or leverage these technologies in a much more efficient manner. So this is where I would love to introduce you all to Solix ECS. This is a cloud and AI-enabled document management system or solution for finance teams. And again, the best part about this whole solution is the cost at which you can get started on. Right? It just starts at $99 per month. It's an enterprise-grade solution with all the security and the compliance capabilities that enterprise need today. And it also brings in the AI capabilities and various automation capabilities all into one single platform, right? And this platform is delivered as a fully managed SaaS service, which means it is fully, you know, your IT team can actually now focus more on strategic initiatives rather than just maintaining document management systems on-prem or trying to help you, you know, discover, you know, or identify information from these various repositories. It's a fully self-service platform for your business users, and then helps you really implement a lot of security and compliance capabilities seamlessly into your workflow. So more important, you know, I think with this ECS platform today, you can now digitize your paper documents. So there are different methods that ECS provides you to go and digitize all of your paper documents. You can scan your documents and input into a centralized cloud-based document management system. If you have legacy file servers, most likely you are dealing with them as well. You can actually now consolidate them into a centralized repository by leveraging your data migration tools, which are again freely accessible within the platform. And then you can actually create secure repositories for each department. For example, the finance department itself can now create its own secure document repository that is not associated or tagged to an individual, you know, a member of the finance team, right? It is now managed centrally by the organization, but, you know, easily accessible to all the members of the work group. And then you also have to deal with a lot of clients and partners on a daily basis. And you're exchanging documents, you're collecting documents, you're collaborating on documents. You can actually now do that not over email or other systems, but now through a centralized repository where you're able to automate the sharing of these, you know, documents and at the same time organizing and collecting these documents as well, right? And then we also have several APIs because we do understand that organizations want to, you know, for you to really break down these silos, you need to be able to ensure you're seamlessly able to integrate the ECS platform or your document management system into all your applications as well. So that's where we have our secure APIs using which you can integrate and build out new applications. For example, a vendor onboarding application, instead of it being a standalone application by itself, it can now leverage ECS in the background, wherein any documents that are being uploaded through the vendor application or the onboarding application can now directly get ingested into ECS and organized appropriately with the required governance capabilities applied progressively as well, right? So essentially there are enough capabilities that will also help you as end users, as IT teams to really work towards consolidating all of your documents into a central cloud repository that is highly scalable and secure. And then I think the other core problem challenge statement that was evident was your ability to retrieve information as well. not just collect information, but also retrieve it. So ECS today provides a modern and intuitive file explorer. And again, this is all role-based access control with all the role-based access controls and privileges in place. You will be able to not only access this from your desktop, but also from your from your iPad or probably from your mobile phone as well. So accessing information at any time and from anywhere is easily possible. And again, all that access is highly secure as well. And then the platform also indexes every single document that comes in, which means you will be able to search and retrieve the documents at any point of time efficiently. And you can actually do the search based on the actual content that is present inside those documents as well. It could be scanned documents. It could be any variety, type of documents that you're bringing in. ECS actually indexes all the content out there and intelligently indexes it and makes it available for you for your search and retrieval processes. And again, you also have the online file viewer, which means you can now view those documents no matter. I think we actually support over 100 plus different file formats today, including video and images, which means you do not need to now download those documents and depend on a source file or a different application to view those documents. You can now efficiently view those documents, access those documents, search for those documents, and view those documents all on the platform without ever having to duplicate or go through any other process around retrieval of the documents too, right? And again, you need to be able to securely share these documents as well. On a daily basis, you are collaborating with your internal teams as well as your external teams. And again, when you're trying to share those documents, you want to be able to share them with a certain level of privileges associated. So the platform now provides enough capabilities for you to restrict or enable users, on what they can do with those documents when sharing as well, right? And also there are times when you need to share large files or also large number of files. And many organizations I've seen end up depending on a file transfer application, which means they're again duplicating the content and again uploading it into one more third-party service. All of that can be now avoided when you're using a centralized cloud document management system like Solix ECS, right? And again, we also have the ability for you to be able to collaborate around those documents. You can edit the documents, you can annotate those documents, you can leave comments and for your other team members or your stakeholders to be able to view and be able to act on it. Or you can even create virtual collections of documents that are relevant for a particular project or for a particular audit, for example. Again, without again having to duplicate all of this data, you're able to now provide seamless access to the relevant teams at all times of the day, right? And we also have seamless integration with Microsoft Office and Google Workspace, which means you'll now be able to edit those documents in an environment that's very familiar to you. Again, based on whatever license that you've been using so far. And again, I think, one of the challenges that we have spoken and we have identified when we were talking to the finance teams is how much time goes into their approval and review processes. Today, organizations also end up using standalone workflow approval, applications. Sometimes they end up using email to be able to follow up on those approval processes, and it takes a lot of time, and a lot of inefficiency creeps in during that approval and review processes. So now with a platform like ECS, as and when the documents are coming in, you can actually create automated workflows that will get triggered on their own, or you can actually go in and manually trigger them if required based on your requirement and enable them to go through either it could be one document or it could be a folder or multiple documents, but you can actually move those documents through a very well-articulated workflow process so that an organization can quickly, your team members can quickly review, act on those documents, collaborate, or send you back comments so that you can rework on those particular documents and then essentially complete the review process as quickly as possible. And all of these audit steps, all of these processes are also audited, which means every single step of your review and approval is audited and available for reviews at any point of time in the future, in the distant future as well, right? And then and a lot of times you're also spending a lot of time on trying to follow up with team members to complete the review or completing the approvals. Instead, now the system will actually automatically continuously remind them based on the time constraints that you have built into your workflow process as well, right? So basically bring in a lot of efficiency into how you're managing your documents, and the processes around those documents too can now be automated using the workflow processes. And again, as we spoke about earlier, you know, I think the governance and the compliance are of very big concern for finance teams, because they're actually containing critical business information, financial information, PI information. There are multiple regulations that mandate how long you need to retain the data. There are regulations that mandate how you share and who can view that data as well, because again, there's a lot of PI information in there. All of that now can be seamlessly managed from the same platform without you having to bring in third-party solutions, or without you having to, you know, do a lot of manual effort around those activities. So the system provides you with capabilities that are progressive in nature, which means you can not only enable governance on data that's already in the system, but as and when the data, new data comes in, appropriate policies, it could be a data retention policy, or it could be a privacy compliance policy, or it could be legal hold. All of those policies can get, you know, quickly taken care of right there. And then, you know, the platform also provides worm storage, because, you know, a lot of regulations like SEC 17A-4, for example, requires that certain type of documents are stored in worm compliant storage. The platform also provides that. Again, data residency has become a major challenge since various governments across different countries have become more cognizant of data privacy, especially with GDPR coming into play. And many more countries are now concerned about where the data is being stored. And ECS today enables you to store your data in the country where you're actually, you know, operating out of, right? Or your business function is operating out of. Which ensures that, okay, you're automatically, you know, compliant with the data residency regulations out there. And again, finally, I think the protection of data itself is also very important. The platform ensures your data is always secure. You know, there's data encryption in place, both for at the time of storage as well as in even when the data is in motion. We have versioning, which is one of the top, you know, key requirements of multiple finance teams, because they want to always have access to the most current and accurate data. I think versioning, you know, plays a very important role. And then you also have redaction capabilities. You know, in case you want to be able to redact information before sharing certain documents, you can do so, all that within the platform itself, right? And then also this platform provides redundant storage and backups. Again, it's a SaaS platform, so all of it is managed by our cloud experts. And thereby, we're able to, you know, offer you 12 nines of data durability, you know, for your critical financial data as well, right? Which is very, very crucial today in a world where there's a lot of data breaches happening. There are a lot of hacks happening, both from internal, you know, entities as well as external entities. The security is of paramount interest for all of your, for all of the organizations out there. So before we, you know, I request Veena to, you know, introduce Imagia and talk about their solutions. Solix also offers AI capabilities, and they're embedded, you know, into ECS across the platform. We have the Solix IDP, which is around intelligent document data extraction and processes. And again, we have partnered with Imagia, you know, who has been around, you know, this company has been around for more than two decades now, helping small, large, and global enterprises manage their financial data and improve their overall cash flow and receivables. So we have partnered with them for enabling the intelligent document data extraction and processing for the finance segment. A great vendor. And again, you know, Veena will talk more in detail. And we'll also touch upon the Solix GPT. This is the solution that will now enable you to securely use or leverage capabilities such as ChatGPT, but in a lot more secure and reliable manner going forward, right? And before that, just a quick poll again, just around AI. Perfect. Thank you. So I can see that, if very, very few out there are actually already using AI in some form or the other, and many of you have responded that you're either exploring, I think 71% are actually said you're exploring how you can leverage AI in your finance department. And some of you, at least 14%, have mentioned that you're planning to implement AI in your finance departments in the next 12 months. Again, thank you for your response. Yeah, over to you, Veena.
Thank you, Kalyan. Quick introduction. Obviously, you've heard about the document cloud management system from Solix. And here I am, Veena Gundavelli, founder and CEO of Imagia. We are focused around bringing autonomous finance to, medium to large enterprises. And we are focused primarily on bringing high efficiency, intelligence, and automation to finance organizations. Our claim to fame is bringing AI, automations, and analytics, all packaged in a platform called Autonomous Finance Platform, and bringing this to, again, enterprises with the high volumes of documents and data and, complex processes that are involved. We've been around and we've, implemented our solutions, especially on order to cash for various different organizations in multiple different segments, industries, as well as, connecting various finance, network systems, ecosystems, such as Oracle, SAP, network, NetSuite, and several others. Moving to today's conversation, let's talk about today's conversation, which is bringing intelligent document processing or cognitive data capture with AI. And let's talk about finance documents. We all know in each of the finance process, whether it is P2P or R2R or O2C or any of the treasury processes, audit, compliance, all of these finance documents are the core. And every finance process relies on many finance documents. And finance documents are identified as the number one challenge in a number of finance organizations, for, driving process efficiency. So one of the things, the key focus of Imagia AI is, bringing together how AI can bring co-pilots, that can read documents just like humans, just that can understand finance documents and that can extract finance documents. So with that, we have introduced, a pre-trained AI called Geodocs AI, which has been around since 2020 and is currently processing several, millions of documents for our customers around the world. So what is Geodocs AI? Geodocs AI is an AI that can read finance documents in multiple formats. Not a fixed format, it can come in multiple formats. And just like a human, finance assistant, it can identify, portions of that particular documents and understand that document and make sense of, the information around that. How does it do? It's built on a AI, technology stack and, brings together a combination of AI technologies, including large language models with the latest Gen AI, deep learning, technologies, neural networks, machine learning, OCR, and several things, put together to be able to, bring out, a very comprehensive, AI for finance documents. So in today's session, I would like to take you to some practical use cases. How is this being used? And, you know, what are, you know, some areas that you can leverage this technology and put it into action in a very, very simple way? So let's go to the next slide. So where can you apply, GeoDocs, right? So first and foremost, GeoDocs is pre-trained for specific categories. As Kalyan mentioned before, one of the challenges with AI is, AI is in general very broad and may or may not be able to bring, you know, the general purpose, general purpose AI may or may not be able to bring you the right level of accuracy. So what Imager has done is, you know, basically trained GeoDocs on thousands hundreds of thousands of documents that are related to accounts receivable, accounts payable, you know, credit management, KYC, order management, treasury management, and we have pre-trained this GeoDocs to identify most common documents that are used in the processes such as credit, order entry, receivables, payables, treasury, and customer financial services. And let's go through, you know, what are some of these use cases. So, one of the key, bottleneck in finance is a lot of documents are either coming in the emails or they're, you know, sitting outside on customer portals or vendor portals. And in most cases, you know, people have to read their inboxes or people have to take the attachments, save it into, you know, some, document management system, you know, float it around, et cetera. So one of the key area that we have applied GeoDocs is, you know, first of all, how as a co-pilot, it's able to read the AR inbox, able to read emails, able to extract the attachments, and able to process that. And it can be accounts receivable inbox, it can be accounts payable inbox. And what type of documents can it, you know, identify and extract? Remittances, for example, on accounts receivable, invoices, you know, coming in from vendors for accounts payable, checks, bank statements, logbox images, purchase orders, sales orders, proof of deliveries, you know, bill of lading documents, your KYC documents coming in from customers, expense reports, and many others. And we'll walk you through, you know, about 5 to 10 use cases today, but this will give, you know, the whole idea is, you know, this should give you a glimpse, but you can experiment with many other documents as we move forward. So let's go to the next slide. So how can you use GeoDocs? First and foremost, if you have a document, simply upload that particular document, just like a file, upload it and start using it. It's as simple as that. Or if you want to use this in an automated way, it has several APIs and you can directly connect this to your, you know, inbox. You know, for example, you can, you know, connect it to the mail inbox, or you can connect it to, you know, your ERP systems or your banks and others, which we'll talk about a little later on how you can, you know, automate with APIs and connectivity. But in order to use that, it's very simple, simply upload your document. Now, what happens after that? GeoDocs extracts that particular document and it gives out all of the extracted fields, most relevant extracted fields. And it also gives you a confidence score of, yes, you know, I'm confident of this extraction, or no, you know, I'm not very confident and here is a red item, right? So this is where, you know, we involve human staff to be able to look at the red items, right? So your staff can look at only the red items and, you know, correct those red items. And that's what we call, you know, again, you know, bringing, you know, humans into the loop. And once you correct that particular, field, then GeoDocs learns that. And for the next time around, it takes care of that, right? So let's look at some of the documents and some of the use cases, you know, where you can use this. Again, you know, most common use cases are what I'm going to talk about. First and foremost, bank logbox images. Today, many finance organizations receive hundreds of, you know, pages of logbox image files, you know, from whether it is, you know, their lockbox, whether it's from JPMC or whether it is Wells Fargo or BMO or several other lockboxes, right? So you receive that file, and you have people looking at that particular file and extracting or typing in that pieces of information, or you're paying the bank for keying in services. Today, Geodocs can take your lockbox image file and simply extract that pieces of information. On the left, you see a portion of the lockbox file with check header. And typically in a lockbox file, you have several pages of files, and Geodocs is able to take all of those several pages of file. On the right, you see it's extracting with a reasonable confidence, in green, it's extracting all the fields. So this is one example of how, if you have a lockbox image, you can simply use Geodocs and, bring, great efficiency. You don't need, a whole lot of time to process thousands of documents. You simply load it up in Geodocs and it's able to extract that for you in minutes. Next, let's look at remittance advisors. When customers do digital payments, your ACH and remittance documents are all coming in the email. And this is where, Geodocs is able to extract a remittance document. This is a simple remittance document. And remittance documents can be coming in from banks also. So this is, an example of one such remittance document. On the right side, you see a very simple extraction of, how Geodocs is able to extract it with confidence. Again, pre-trained for accuracy. Next. This use case is for accounts payable. In accounts payable, again, you receive invoices, from your vendors. And these invoices may come in email or it's coming into your AP inbox. And these invoices, come in several different formats. Each vendor has their own format. And it's not a simple, easy way to be able to, put a bot to read that particular document, because the documents itself, the documents themselves come in various formats. So this is where Geodocs AI is trained to understand different formats. Any type of invoice that comes in, it is able to identify invoice header information, invoice line item information, and able to extract, right to the right? So this is one such example of how a document extraction, works for accounts payable. Bringing efficiency. Next, let's go to treasury. Treasury departments deal quite a bit with the bank files. You have bank statements. You have daily bank statements. You have monthly bank statements. You have analysis statements. You have ACH statements. The wire statements. A lot of those kind of documents come in, right? So this is where Geodocs is pre-trained to read your bank statements and to be able to extract those pieces of information and, bring out, all of this in a neatly extracted manner, right? So this is one, one such example. And again, you can have any leading banks, whether it's a Bank of America or Citibank or any others, we are able to extract. Next use case is on the wire document. Bank wires, large companies have several, wire documents processed. And, this is where, when you receive such documents, extracting these and making sure that you're able to store all of these pieces of information, right? So imagine, having, hundreds and, hundreds and thousands of, ACH and wire documents on a monthly basis. Geodocs, can simply extract all of this and, make this available. And you see all of the greens. The greens show that, the Geodocs is able to extract with confidence. Anything red means it needs your attention. So let's go to the next use case. This is again an ACH document, coming in from the bank, and it's pre-trained to extract, all the different, different fields, such as the bank reference, the credit amount, the transaction ID, account numbers, which date, it has been processed, the currency amounts. All of these, it's able to extract, and this is one such example. So another use case is around the checks as well as check stubs. And this is where, you see the check header information and the stub information. Now remember, the stub information has a lot of important information, such as, which invoice it got paid for, and what is the amount it got paid for, any discounts that are taken. All of these pieces of information are very important, to be able to, again, post cash, as well as, when you're processing, the credits and, write-offs, all of these pieces of information are very important. And this is where all of these extraction can now be done in a very seamless way. So this is one such example of check and a check stub. So all in all, what is Geodocs doing? Geodocs AI is primarily, taking all of your finance documents and, aiming to get to a 90 to 95% touchless document processing. What does that mean? What it means is it now brings tremendous efficiency on document data extraction. You can now use the data, put it in your finance data lake, and you can run analytics, you can run, trend reports, you can run, fraud detection, as well as, you can create, automated processes. And you can, primarily have this as the core and foundation for improving the efficiency on your processes, such as order to cash, or your KYC credit customer onboarding, such as P2P procure to pay, such as your treasury management, or your audit and compliance. All of those processes can be automated in a very seamless way. And let's go through one such example. And this is a case study of a medical device supplier. This is a global supplier with revenues over $4 billion. And this company, again, has several bank accounts where, the bank information, the bank documents, are coming in on a daily basis. ACH as well as wires, coming in, and the remittance advisors coming in various different email inboxes. This is a global company, and remittance advisors, are coming in from many different countries and in many different languages. So this is where, Geodocs, is embedded into an entire process of cash application, where incoming documents from the banks and from the emails are both fed into Geodocs. All of the extraction and validations, and confidence scoring is all happening in Geodocs. And from there, we feed that right into the Imaja automated cash application process, in the Imaja cash application, do the three-way auto matching between the invoices, remittances, as well as the invoices, post it automatically into the ERP system, and save all of these documents in Solix ECS. So you have a complete automated order to cash, cash application, and a fully compliant document storage available. So this is how we are bringing together, both AI as well as, cloud management, and automating the entire process, as well as, keeping the compliance on the documents, supporting documents, and being available for rest of the teams. Another example, deductions, coming in from various different retail providers. So this is an example for a CPG company, where the company is you know, selling its products on Amazon, Walmart, and several other Costco, several other retail providers. The deductions and the claims documents, you know, are coming in, you know, into the system. GeoDocs is able to process all of those and, you know, send that for collaboration, for approvals, you know, for, you know, credits and other, you know, write-offs, etc., as well as, you know, provide information for cash application. All of that is able to happen in a very automated manner, and all these documents are stored in Solix ECS. You know, a lot of supporting documents, whether it is proof of deliveries, the PODs, or the BOLs, or the claims documents, or the invoices, the remittance, all of that, you know, are able to, you know, come into GeoDocs, get processed, and stored into ECS. So this is how, in a very integrated way, we are able to pull this all together. So again, you know, GeoDocs has integrations to multiple different, you know, systems and APIs available to leading ERP systems for automatic posting. So with that, let me, you know, hand this over to Kalyan. And I know we are having in the last 5 minutes. So let's go to the next slide, Kalyan.
Great. Thank you, Veena. And I think it was great, you know, hearing all the use cases and the specific, you know, examples that you used. I think GeoDocs is one of those proven AI solutions for the finance teams, and we're glad to be partnering with Imagia on this front. And again, and the whole goal of ECS is to be able to not only help our customers manage their data better, but also in documents better, but also be able to help them leverage the best of the and the latest AI technologies as well. And Imagia and the GeoDocs, you know, brings in that capability, you know, to all our customers today. And again, as you can see, you know, the GeoDocs integration essentially converts all of the unstructured data into a structured format for various use cases. And what we also do is leverage that structured data that's being extracted out and use it for reducing not only manual data entry processes, but also for enriching the metadata around those documents as well, because we have metadata templates that you can create and assign them towards those documents and enrich that metadata so that you can search better. You'll be able to identify the documents better. You could also use that data for classifying your documents or enabling data retention policies on top of it. At the same time, you can also enable intelligent workflows. For example, you want invoices of certain, you know, or let's say an expense claim of certain dollar value to be routed to a certain team and higher than that, routed to, let's say, the CFO. You can actually do all of that now thanks to the intelligent document processing enabled by GeoDocs, right? And then just very briefly, I'll mention that, okay, we also are bringing in the ChatGPT-like capability to all the finance teams today. You can now not only chat with the documents, you can ask questions, you can request summaries, and you can also use Solix GPT to create templatized, you know, basic templates of, let's say, a Dunning letter, right? So instead of you trying to go through and writing a whole long letter, you can actually provide all the key data points that you want to be included in the Dunning letter, and the Solix GPT can now generate that letter for you instantly. So an activity that would have probably taken 15, 20 minutes can now be done in just maybe a few minutes, right? So the whole idea is to be able to help finance teams improve their efficiency, and so that they can and also improve their productivity and remove all the manual you know and cumbersome activities that they're generally, you know, working on and replace it with AI and the cloud technologies that we are able to, you know, bring to Solix ECS. Thank you, Brian. Oh yeah, by the way, I think another key aspect is, you know, we do have a 30-day free trial of Solix ECS. So I highly recommend that you go and sign up for the 30-day free trial. And we will also have, whenever you sign up for a 30-day free trial, we also have a you know, customer onboarding team that works alongside to help you understand the platform and then see how it can how you can benefit. So please do leverage this feature. And then if you need a personalized demo of the product, you know, I know we did not get a chance to showcase either the ECS or the GeoDocs actual products, you know, we'll be happy to schedule personalized demos. So feel free to reach out to us at either ecs@solix.com or imagiainfo@imagia.com. Thank you.
Well, I mean, thank you, Talian and Vina. Those presentations were incredibly insightful. We're going to go ahead and begin our question and answer session. For those of you attending here, if you've not done so already, please type in any question you have for our speakers on this topic now in the chat. And do remember, as I said, if we don't get to your question, we'll be happy to try to follow up with that by email with an answer for you sometime in the next couple of days. So let's take a look at what we have coming in. First question, looks like for Vina. How does your system flag challenges in data extraction and accuracy? And how do you know when a manual sort of review is required?
We have a very clear, visual indication indicators, on the data that is extracted. So everything that the system is confident and that it matches with, some of the data that's already available as a core, it signals as green. And if the AI is not, giving, the right level of accuracy, it automatically, brings out a red, red outline or a red dot, right around the document or the data. So it's a very clear indication of a green flag or a red flag. And, the red flags are where the humans are supposed to take a closer look at it and give the information.
Thanks for that. And this is related to ChatGPT. Everyone became familiar with that here in the last year. There is a Solix GPT and a Gia GPT out there right now. So I guess we'll start with Kalyan. If you could talk a little bit about Solix GPT and how that's similar and how that's different from the ChatGPT that people might know really well.
Yeah, no, thank you. So if you see, the ChatGPT, the technology, the foundational technologies are all very similar, right? So OpenAI and Solix ECS, Solix GPT, we kind of leverage the same set of technologies. It could be the natural language processing or what you also refer to as NLP, the machine learning and AI. And on top of it, we have the LLM, the large language models that we also leverage. But the key significant difference is that the Solix GPT is not a publicly available platform. And also it does not train on the customer data. So thereby ensuring the highest level of governance and security and also reliability for customers that their information is not leaking to the public domain. It's always going to be within the private domain of that customer. So that's the biggest difference of what we offer. And again, more important, it's also an integrated service as part of ECS, which means you're not essentially trying to download and upload documents to a third-party service. It's all right there within the Solix ECS platform, and you can seamlessly call the Solix GPT to chat with the documents or request summaries or analyze the documents. Yeah,
great. So it sounds like a lot more peace of mind than public cloud type.
Absolutely.
That's wonderful. I know a lot of people have that front of mind. Okay, next question. Let's see. Do you provide professional services to help with migration to the cloud or for integration with your products and services with the existing ERP systems that that most companies would be operating under right now?
Absolutely. So, Solix has been around for more than 2 decades now, right? And we actually have a very strong professional services team. And I think we are known for our quality of service and our quality and our focus on customer success. So, and the professional services team plays a very important role there. We do help customers, not only plan their migrations, but also execute on the migration as well. And we have several methods based on the size of the data involved. We have several methods that are typically, that can come in. And we also have the secure APIs And we have our dev team that actually directly involves with existing integrations that we support. And if there's any new integration, we always work with our customers to extend the ECS platform to those integrations as well. And I think this is also probably a great point for Veena to probably comment on, because you know the amount of information that is being extracted out of the documents, you know, leveraging AI today, then how that can streamline the data flow into ERP systems can be, transformational, you know, for many finance team members, right? So Veena, do you have a comment on that?
Sure. I think, you know, straight through processing is one of the main use case, and we'll be happy to provide more information around this. And, in case of each of these entries into the ERP systems, right from the documents, again, you know, the same day processing as well as instant update into ERP systems are now possible with our API solutions. So we'll be happy to provide more information. I know we're, you know, few minutes past the hour, so again, you know, let people know that we will come back to you with these questions in a with answers in a more detailed way. Thank you.
Of course, cost is an issue that everybody holds dear to heart. So let's talk about that a little bit. You said, Kalyan, your pricing starts at $99 per month. What all is included in that? If you could just kind of go over that again for us.
Okay, sure. Yeah, I think this is probably a relevant question. I'm sure a lot of people are thinking, you know, $19 sounds pretty low cost. Not many capabilities might be included, but the fact is, we have priced the platform to help organizations of all sizes, being able to adopt cloud and AI technologies. So the $99 essentially brings all the capabilities that are available as part of the document management. And then again, we also embed a certain units of the Geodocs an automated data extraction capability as well as part of the service. And there's a very large number of users that you can actually add. You know, the $19 plan, which is like the basic plan itself, also allows up to 50 users, you know, to be brought onto the platform. And as I said, again, all the capabilities are available. And we also have additional plans like Business Plus and Enterprise Plus, which enable you to have even unlimited users as part of the your platform usage. The whole idea is to really help, you know, finance teams really transform how they operate and manage their documents going forward.
All right. Well, looking at the clock, it seems like we are unfortunately out of time. Again, if your question hasn't been answered, or if you have one you'd like to pose, feel free to send that out to us. You can reach me at pr@imagia.com or imagiainfo@imagia.com. Want to give a big thanks to Kalyan and Veena for your time today. I know you're very busy. That was incredibly insightful material that you've shared with us today. And I want to thank all of you in attendees here who've taken time out of your busy schedule to attend this rare joint webinar between Imagia and Solix. Again, we'll be making a recording of this webinar available very soon. At any rate, we're signing out now. Have a great day.